These ants are driving me nuts. I can't seem to get rid of them no matter what I do. I need help.
Got ant problems? If you are in California, they are probably Argentine ants, which are among the most difficult to manage. This video will help you identify, understand, and manage the Argentine ant. Argentine ants are small, but not tiny. They're about 1/8 of an inch long and uniformly dull brown in color. Their color distinguishes them from southern fire ants that are usually two-toned, red and brown, and red imported fire ants that are uniformly reddish-brown. If you look at Argentine ants under a microscope, you will see just one node at the front of their abdomen. Many other common ants have two nodes. If you squash them, there may be a musty odor, but not a strong odor like the odorous house ant or velvety tree ant. Unlike some other ant species, Argentine ants cannot sting and rarely bite. Argentine ants normally nest outdoors in shallow mounds, in soil, under debris, or along sidewalks and driveways. They prefer areas with adequate moisture. Worker ants travel hundreds of feet from their nests, often into buildings, to find food to bring back to feed queens, immatures, and other ants in the colony. Argentine ants prefer sugary, sweet food, although they will occasionally feed on protein, such as dead insects. Spills of sugary liquids or other sugary food, as well as ripening fruit in the garden, honeydew produced by aphids or other insects, or sugar water in hummingbird feeders are favored. Argentine ants are moisture-loving ants, so are particularly drawn to liquid food sources. Colonies find new food sources by sending scouts out to forage. Scouts leave the nest along a zigzag meandering path until they find food. Once food is found, the scout heads straight back to the nest, leaving an odor trail along the way. Back in the nest, the scout shares the food with its nest mates, and they follow the odor trail back to the food source.
Why are there so many ants in my house? My neighbors don't have them.
Why do Argentine ants invade your home? Worker ants must support a large, ever-expanding colony and are constantly in search of new food sources. If you have ant nests very near your house, you are likely to have frequent invasions. Nesting materials like wood debris, mulch, or plants close to your foundation may increase the likelihood of invasion. Plants that produce sugary fruit or nectar or have honeydew-producing insects like aphids on them also attract ants and grow colonies. Water sources such as dripping taps or air conditioning drains also draw ants close to structures. Once inside, if ants find food, they are likely to continue to invade until the food source goes away or until entryways are sealed up. People often notice ant invasions during heat waves or after rainstorms. These weather events drive ants into homes for protection against heat, wet, or cold. So what is an effective approach to managing Argentine ants? The focus of a home ant management program should be to keep ants out of the house. It isn't realistic to eradicate ants from a backyard, but outdoor numbers can be reduced. Use a step-by-step integrated approach. The first step is to assess your problem by inspecting your home inside and out for ants, potential entryways, and nesting sites. Next, you must remove food and nesting sites identified in your inspection and seal up entryways. If ant problems are not reduced through these activities, the third step is to use bait stations in appropriate locations around the exterior of your home. Home-use insecticide sprays are not generally recommended.
How can I find out where these ants are coming from?
The first step to a comprehensive ant management program is to inspect your home inside and out for ants, potential entryways, and attractive nesting sites. Start by drawing a simple diagram of the floor plan of your house and landscape. Carry this with you as you inspect and mark places where you see ant activity or places where ants could enter. Start your inspection inside and, using a flashlight, systematically inspect around the entire house, focusing on baseboards and walls where they meet the floor or the ceiling. Ants often trail along these edges. Potted plants may also provide harborage for ants. Inspect electrical outlets, vents, electrical fixtures, and under furnishings. In kitchens, bathrooms, and other rooms where you have plumbing, open cabinets to inspect pipes and drains. Ants often forage in these areas for water. Look for possible attractive food sources, such as sweets or pet food. Outside, inspect the walls of the structure as low and as high as possible for ant trails. Pay special attention to locations where ants were found inside for possible entry points that could be sealed up with caulk. Branches of trees or shrubs touching the house may provide pathways for ants. Also inspect for ants in trees and shrubs in the landscape that might harbor aphids, soft scales, or other honeydew-producing insects. Check potted plants, leaf litter, mulch, rocks, or wood piles for ant nests, especially in moist areas. Look for attractive food sources such as pet food. Note and fix leaky faucets or sprinklers that provide water sources for ants. Carry out outdoor inspections in the morning or later afternoon. Ants tend to retreat to their nests when it is hot and very sunny midday. After you have completed your inspection, go back and fix any problems you have found. Seal up all potential entry spots, both inside and out, with caulk. Fix leaky faucets, pipes, or sprinkler heads, both inside and outside. Water is a limiting factor in ant survival, and the reduction of water sources for ants will make liquid baits more attractive and effective. Manage honeydew-producing insects on trees and shrubs near the house. Keep ants out of these trees with sticky barriers, or remove these plants from the landscape. Prune back branches touching the building that may provide pathways for ants. Remove wood piles, piles of debris, or litter next to the house that may provide good nesting sites. Also remove any plants growing within 6 inches of the foundation.
So how do I control my ants?
You have to investigate your situation. The tools at work will vary depending on the severity of your ant problem.
The tools you will need to manage ants depends on how serious your problem is. In some cases, sealing ant entryways and eliminating attractive food sources will be all you need to keep ants out of your home. In other cases, you will need to take additional steps, including using baits. Here are some examples. Ants often move into buildings when major weather changes occur. For instance, with the first heat wave of the summer, or when there is a big rain. In some cases, ants will forage around the home for a few days, but may disappear after a few days to a week if they don't find any food. Usually only a few dozen ants are seen at a time. For these types of temporary invasions, it is often enough to sponge up the ants with soapy water, seal up cracks where ants are entering the home, and be sure that any potential food sources, especially sweets, are not available. If ants go away in a week or two following these measures, this is all the management that may be necessary. If ants continue to invade the home for more than a week or two, and residents are consistently seeing trails of hundreds of ants, the problem requires additional attention. The first step is to make a closer inspection of the home indoors and out to determine how the ants are entering. Check again for food sources, especially sweets, that may be attracting the ants into the house or around the foundation of the house. Also look for materials outside and near the house, such as moist mulch or wood debris, that may provide good nesting sites. Supplement these activities with the use of ant baits. If high numbers of ants, several hundred to thousands, are still invading your home a month or more after taking the steps mentioned on the previous two screens, then you have a severe ant problem. To effectively manage this level of ants, you can install specialized refillable bait dispensers around the outside of your home. You will need to regularly refill the dispensers with liquid borate-based bait. Research has shown that this approach can effectively keep ants at tolerable levels. Even when using these bait stations, it is still important to remove sweet food sources that may attract ants away from the bait and to seal up entryways to your home to the extent possible. Baits are insecticides mixed with materials that attract worker ants. Worker ants take the bait back to the nest to feed the colony. The advantage of baits is that they kill the ants in the colony, not just the workers in the trail, as is the case with insecticide sprays. Baiting takes patience. Baits must be slow-acting so workers are not killed before they can take the bait to the colony. It could take 7 to 10 days or more before you see results, and it could take several weeks before the problem goes away.
I've tried baits, but they never seem to work.
Only certain baits are effective against Argentine ant, and you have to use them correctly.
Many people have tried ant baits to control Argentine ant problems, but have not had success. Choice of bait attractant, pesticide active ingredient, and bait dispenser are critical for obtaining good control. Argentine ants prefer liquid baits with sweet attractant. Borate products, such as disodium octaborate tetrahydrate, with a 0.5 to 1.0% concentration of active ingredient, are most effective for Argentine ants. Look on the label to find the active ingredient and percent concentration. Other products may work well for other ant species. Higher concentrations of borate may repel or kill many ants before they can take the bait back to the colony. Most prepackaged baits contain higher concentrations of borate, often around 5%. They can be effective at killing foragers, which may provide enough control for low-level infestations, but will not be effective for severe infestations, where the whole colony must be significantly reduced. To get the most out of baits, remove any food sources such as sugary foods, pet food, and water sources that might compete with the bait's attractiveness. Do not spray pesticides around bait stations or on ant trails leading to them. You do not want to kill ants before they can bring the bait back to their colonies. Use baits primarily outdoors near known entryways to houses. If you place them indoors, they may continue to attract ants inside. Remember, if colonies are large, it may take 1 to 2 weeks to see a significant reduction in ants, even when baits are working well. Prepackaged bait stations are the most common products on the market and the easiest to use. Unfortunately, they generally are not effective against severe ant infestations. They may be helpful in managing low to moderate levels of ants if used in combination with sealing up entryways and removing attractants. Look on the label for the active ingredient and percent concentration. Stations with 5% or more of borate are likely to repel or kill ants before they can bring the bait back to the colony. Prepackaged baits may dry up rapidly and must be replaced frequently. Since Argentine ants are attracted to liquids, granular baits are not very effective. Baits may attract ants into your house, so don't place them indoors unless you are unable to find trails around your structure outdoors. If placed indoors, place them at the site where the ants are entering your home, such as under a kitchen or bathroom cabinet, or along windowsills or doors, or next to electrical outlets. Remove them as soon as the ants are gone. Borate or fipronil gel baits can be useful for treating protected areas indoors, such as under cabinets or along ant travel ways in cracks or crevices. Refillable bait stations are the best choice for managing moderate to severe infestations. Argentine ants can consume enormous amounts of liquid bait in a short time, and refillable stations are the best way to keep up with the ants' needs. Several designs are available. University of California researchers have had success using bait dispensers such as the KM AntPro liquid bait dispenser that provide ants with continuous access to the bait. Remember to use baits that are 1% or less borate. The liquid bait is released into the feeding tray only when the ants access the station. As a result, bait discharge is regulated by consumption rate of the ants, and the bait in the upper reservoir is kept fresh. These stations are water resistant. The placement suggestions discussed here are based on University of California experience with the AntPro dispenser. These units are more expensive than other stations, but also the most durable and effective.
Okay, let's remove the reservoir bulb to see the actual base of the bait station, the mechanism of releasing the bait. As you can see in a close-up, it has stress ducts at the base. The ants actually have to trip that in order to have the bait released into this well, the feeding well, around the base of the bait station. And the diaphragm at the bottom of the neck here is the actual, you screw the reservoir down, it seals the bait in so that it can't be released. Okay, we're going to fill the bait station first, unscrewing the base of the station. Then taking the liquid bait here, we're going to put about a half a bottle in. Screw the base back down on the reservoir. Tight, so it's sealed. Turn it over, and you're ready to place the bait station. We have a stake for inserting in the ground as an anchor. Okay, we're going to insert it in the ground. If it's real hard soil, you might need to start the hole with a screwdriver. Once you have it stationed in the ground, you merely turn it half turn. The arrow joins up with the other arrow on the base of the station and it's activated. Yeah, in order to determine if there's any bait left in the station, merely tap on the reservoir sound for a hollow sounding, empty sound. You can tell whether you need to add bait or not.
Once your dispensers are installed, check them regularly to be sure they still have a good supply of bait. If you still have ants around the structure, they should be trailing into the dispenser. Refill is necessary. Rinse out dispensers every few months to keep them clean. Pour the rinsate on the ground around the bait station. After several weeks or months, you may find that the ants are no longer visiting the dispensers and your ant problems have cleared up. You may keep the dispensers in place for future invasions. Rinse out the dispensers and screw the base back on tightly. Lock with the security screw. Fill again when you see ant activity near your house. To use the AntPro bait stations, you will need to install at least one dispenser on each side of your house. Larger homes may require 6 to 8 or more dispensers. Use approximately one dispenser for every 400 to 500 square feet. Ideally, dispensers should be installed next to the structures where ants are trailing, but at least 5 feet from nests, out of direct sunlight, and under shrubs if possible. The north or shady side of the house often has more ant activity. Ants often converge in larger numbers where walls jut out and make acute angles. Avoid locations where the dispenser may be submerged in water by irrigation or downspout runoff. However, placing a dispenser next to the air conditioner water overflow is often a good idea because ants are attracted to water.
This program sounds great. But is it safe? I heard that pesticides were getting into our creeks and rivers. What about my dog? Could he be injured by these baits?
One of the advantages of IPM programs for ants that use baits is their safety for people, pets, and the environment. In addition to being more effective than homeowner treatments with traditional insecticide spray programs or perimeter treatments with insecticides, they are also less toxic. Placing baits in secure bait stations prevents them from moving from the application site and into storm drains. However, never let children or pets play with any bait stations. We hope this video provides you with the information you need to solve ant problems around your home. If you need more information, contact your county UC Cooperative Extension office and the UC Master Gardeners, or visit the University of California Integrated Pest Management website.